last question for further explanation. We are moving straight to my dear friend, Mr. Sada Kashmiri, President of the United Kashmir People's National Party, who will be talking to us again on the theme Participation of Women in Peace and Conflict Resolution Processes. We expect that as president in the making, what do you have for women in your next government? Thank you very much. Take the floor.
I thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I would like to thank you for your participation and also my gratitude to APROPOS team, and special thanks and gratitude to Madam Madam Micheline. She organized such a wonderful conference on women rights. And at this moment, I think it's very important to all of us, and especially when there is many areas which is falling in the conflict zones, and the women's rights is more compromised, and their suffering is too much. Human rights are the basic rights and a freedom that belongs to every person in the world. These rights should be granted from the birth until death. These basic rights are based on shared values like dignity, freedom, fairness, equality, respect, and independence. Democracy has expanded and deepened the concept of human rights to economic and cultural rights also. Millions of people have dedicated and sacrificed their lives to uplift, uphold, update, and upgrade the human rights. And they have not fallen from the sky. People have to be vigilant to protect human rights. We can today discuss about right in two aspects, as national level and the international sphere. Extremists got tremendous boost by the Taliban victory. Pakistan should abandon the Indian-centric policies and should try to save the life, liberty, and honor of the citizen under their control. We believe gender equality. There are many parts of the world where women have not equal rights. Many women facing discrimination and deprivations. In many parts of the world, especially in Pakistan, under the patronage of the government, some groups force the women to marriage and also force them to change their religion. Like in Sindh, there are many Hindus, in Punjab, many Christians. Women are forced to change their religion and also force them to marry with the patronage peoples also. And especially in Afghanistan, everybody knows the most sufferer of that society is the woman. And one community also watching that, but unfortunately they are unable to protect their life, their liberty, and their personalities. It all compromised due to the extremists which are supported and financing some of the countries like Pakistan. And I have personal experience because I belong to that part of area which is divided and forcibly divided and occupied. And at that time, when we were occupied, most of the women was gang raped, murdered, and ultimately forced them to leave that area. And it is all in our area, which is known as Azad Kashmir. Actually, it is not Azad. It is the colony of Pakistan. And every day, we receive the reports. Women are raped and murdered. And nobody is ready to protect them. And courts, it is unfortunate that in our areas, all the courts are compromised and living under pressure of the establishment, especially the military establishment. I just quote one case. There is one girl. She was actually, her parents forced her to marry one person, but she was not ready. Ultimately, the parents forced her to leave the area. And one of the persons who filed a habeas corpus petition, that we have doubt that their parents killed her because she is not ready to marry with the person which is not liked by him. And the court only one time issued the notice, but lately, within 1 week, he dismissed the petitions without pressurizing to appear that lady in the courts, because habeas corpus petitions main theme is to present that disappeared persons. And many women in different part of Pakistan, they are killed with immunity. And even they are not safe, those who seek asylum in Canada or somewhere else. So it is very grim situation regarding human rights and especially the woman dignity. So I think we should ask the United Nations and all the concerned authorities to put pressure on those regimes which are not honored the human rights and especially the women dignity. I will not take your much time because you have listened very lengthy speech of the professor and he covered all the aspects. I don't like to repeat anything which he already said because it is the wastage of time if we repeat. Maybe our time will contribute to other speakers. I thank you very much. And thank you again, Madam and Mrs. Chairman, to give me this opportunity to address the subject.
I told you that he was my dear friend, a man of few words that says everything. And I'm sure you picked one key word.